If my wife were talking to you today, she would tell you that her husband has a disease called Quickenitis. And what I mean by that is I use a piece of budgeting software for our household called Quicken, and I've been doing it for decades. I'm just kind of obsessed. I mean, I have been that way since a child. Even when I got my first allowance, I'd be like, okay, I've got $3. This is something that I really want. I've got to save for it. And I would kind of plan very carefully. And I guess I bring that same carefulness to the All of Us research program. I wish we had unlimited funds. If we do, this could be a study of 10 million people. It could be a study of 100 million people. But like you and your household and me and mine, we don't have unlimited funds, and we've got to sometimes make hard choices. So as we aim for a million diverse people from all walks of life, from different geographies, different rural urban settings, different parts of the country with different weather, and as we aim for people who have a real mix of health status, some who are completely healthy, some who have particular conditions, we've got to make sure that that diversity works, because it's fundamental to the scientific breakthroughs that this whole study is designed for. That's going to mean two things. First, it's going to mean we're not going to be able to afford to invite everybody to the more expensive parts of the study. It is expensive doing a blood draw and running an analysis on that. It is expensive taking a urine sample or getting people to do simple physical measurements like coming in to get your height and weight and blood pressure, which is part of our protocol. So we're going to have to make choices. We want everybody to consent to the study, share their electronic health record data, do as many surveys as possible, and as we start to add some online tools and games, things that might tell you about your health while you play a game, the more people that do that, the better. In fact, that in itself is going to be a game changer for the kind of science that can be done. But we'll be looking based on how we're doing and, okay, we've got too many people in that part of the country. We can't take any more people there. We need to focus here. Or we've got too many people with this condition. All right, we can't take any more people with that. We need to now focus on this particular area. And those will be hard choices and trade-offs that we make to make this a scientifically useful resource. The other piece of this is, we have this great network of direct volunteer partners. That's for all of the folks who come through saying, I got online or I clicked on an app and I joined, and your doctor or your health plan may not be associated as one of our health provider organization partners. That's great. You can go online, do the consent, do it on your phone, start to take your surveys. And then we're gonna have to look and see, wow, there's a lot of people in that part of the country. We can do some pop-up capacity. And what I mean by that is with big players like Walgreens or Quest, many of you may have your lab work or get your prescriptions there, we can say, hey, can you guys open up for 4 to 6 months to be able to get the blood draws, the urine samples, and the physical measurements taken from all those people? So if you've been waiting a month or 6 months or even potentially 18 months, you know, we may take that long before we say, okay, we're gonna come with our All of Us research parade in town for 4 to 6 months and help you get through the rest of the protocol. And it also means not everybody will be invited to do that. But if I win the lottery, I will add more of you all the time. I'm excited about and appreciative of your volunteering, and every bit that you give helps.